one who speaks in a tongue speaks not to men but to God. For no one understands him, but he utters mysteries in the spirit. On the other hand, the one who prophesies speaks to people for their upbuilding and encouragement and consolation. The one who speaks in a tongue builds up himself, but the one who prophesies builds up the church.
I speak unto thee this day, and I say, confound the demons. Confound the demons that are throughout the land. That is, by taking the week that you are in to thank me and praise me, and literally live in a festival of praise unto me. For I say you are living in a time when men are steeped in ingratitude and murmuring and complaining, in finding fault in everything that is in their lives. But I say that I, the living God, delight when my own people will take the time to be thankful unto me. And I say, if you find yourself slipping into ingratitude and murmuring and complaining against me, I say, quickly repent. That is, harness your own mouth, harness your own thoughts, and bring them into subjectivity unto me. For I say, it is me, the living God, you are meant to be pleasing. It is me, the living God, you are meant to follow after and obey. And it is me, the living God, who will ever direct, correct, and guide you forth, for indeed you are mine. Now I say this day that I, the living God, never called my people to live in the treachery, the darkness, the evil of their own way. But I say that I've called my people to be uplifted and brought forth, guided and directed each day by me. For I say, when a people will be found abiding in me, I say they are in the power of my presence. But I say, when a people will stray from me to go whoring after the world, I say they will be damned in the same. I say, this day when men are under the covering of the world, then I say they have this agreement with me. That is, they are hateful, they are rebellious, they are proud and defiant, and think they own the world. But I say they are fools who are merely deceived, ready to be damned by their choices against me. And I say, it is me, the living God, who is giving forth the call to all to repent, to return to me. I say, there are those who will stubbornly, proudly refuse me, resist me, and go on in their own hell-bent ways. And I say, there are those who will literally end in hell because of the stubbornness and hardness of heart. But I say, likewise, there are those who will see the error of their way, repent, and return to me. And I say, for the same, be thankful, be thankful, be thankful each day. For I say you are meant to be thankful when you see men come in out of darkness and into the glorious light. For I say that the same transformation has been in your own lives. And I say you are not meant to discount that transformation and give way to the hammering of the evil one that seeks to drive a wedge between you and me. For I say you are not meant to be separated from me, but I say you are meant to be one in me, for I am thy God, thy maker, thy source. And I say, when you walk in the truth, the light, the mercy that I give, then I say you can be thankful unto me. Now I say it is true that the world is wearied with its own wickedness, and I say there are those who are groaning to be delivered from the same. That is why I am calling forth for my true messengers to declare the call to repentance, revolution, that the obedient would hear and come into my way. For I say that my way is righteousness, my way is truth, and my way is mercy provided. And I say, when a people will believe upon me, cleave unto me, then I say they are brought forth by me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, never intended that my own people would be taken in the way of the stubborn, the proud, the foolish, and likewise damned. But I say that I've intended that my people would be uplifted, strengthened, and ever guided by me. That is, guided forth in the truth, the light, the mercy of who I am, and given my truth always. For I say, when you will be cleaving unto me, believing in me, then I say you are guided forth by me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do intend that my own people would be faithful, would be true, would be steady in me. That is, that they would know, understand, and recognize that it is me they are meant to serve each day. For I say, if you will be coming forth in servitude unto me, in gladness to be redeemed, then I say it is me, the living God, who will give my light unto thee. And it is me, the living God, who will cause you to be guided forth each day by me. Now I say this day, while the world is full of complaint, while the world is full of unrest and fear on every hand, I say, why not soar higher than they are? That is, by living in the attitude of gratitude, giving thanks and praise unto me. For I say, it is me, the living God, who will indeed bring you forth if you are trusting in me. and it is me, the living God, who will keep thee in safety if you look to me as your shield. I say this day, consider that I, the living God, do guide you forth each day as you continue to trust, to believe, to hope in me. And I say, consider that I do give unto thee the strength to continue steadfast as you are ever believing and hoping in me. For I say it is a good thing, a wondrous thing, a beautiful thing to be brought forth, ever knowing the truth, the light, and the mercy of who I am. For I say it is me, the living God, who will keep thee each and every day as you continue to walk in my way. Now I say this day that I, the living God, never called men to identify themselves with the death that is impending for those who reject me. But I say that I've intended that the ones who hear my call obey the call to repentance would be identified with life. For I say it is me, the living God, who desires a living people. That is, why should I find pleasure in those who are dead in trespasses and sins, when if they repent, they can be born again of incorruptible seed. And I say that they can come in out of the death into the glorious life that I provide. Now I say this day, consider that if you truly will thank me and praise me and serve me in the attitude of gratitude, that you are uplifted by me. And yes, you are directed, corrected, and given the hope of who I am, for it is me, the living God, who is well able to give you the same. And it is me, the living God, who is able to guide you forth each day in the newness of life, the strength, the truth, and the mercy of who I am. Therefore I say, be steady, be true, be faithful unto me. For I say that I, the living God, have not called my people to weary me with rebellion, to weary me with defiance and stubbornness against my way. And I say, when my people will put away those childish antics to cooperate with me, then of course they are pleasing me. I say this day, when any man or woman will continue in true repentance, then I say they are humble to see their need of me. And I say they are thankful to be ever guided forth in the light, the truth of who I am. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am well aware of the evil plots, the schemes, the agendas of wicked men, but I say that my own people are meant to keep trusting in me. For I say it is me, the living God, who is well able to confound the wicked and bring their plots to naught. And it is me, the living God, who will indeed punish evildoers, and I say that I will bring them to the destruction of their souls. For I say they are the ones who are choosing the way of their own wickedness and trusting in the same. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call you to cater to men, but I say that I call you to seek to be pleasing me. And I say that I call you to be directed each day by me, because it is me, the living God, you are meant to please. That is, you are not meant to be in subjectivity to the opinions of men, for the same will weaken your walk with me. And I say, when you cater to men, to women, you are catering to fools. Now I say this day, consider how ugly it is to me when my own people will give up the truth and the light, will give up bearing witness of me to cater to men, to cater to women, who are nothing but fools in their own carnality. For I say, when men have not repented and returned to me, I say they are blinded fools led in their folly. And I say that it is indeed a grief unto me when my own people turn aside from me to gain favorable opinions of men. For I say, when you are seeking favor with men, you are seeking for lies. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call you to compromise, but I say that I call you to walk uprightly each day in me. That is, continuing to declare the call to all to repent, for all men are needy of the same. And I say, when men will proudly, defiantly, stubbornly resist that call, then they are the ones who are held accountable for their own souls. For I say, when a man has heard the call, resisted, and refused the call, no, such a man is a fool. I say this day, be thankful that I, the living God, will uplift, direct, and guide you forth each day, if you will continue to believe and receive of me. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way that is righteousness and truth, the way that is mercy and light, and the way that is peace provided. And it is me, the living God, who gives to the ones who will obey me the way wherein they can be kept by me. That is the way of life eternal, the way of truth and strength and mercy each day. Now I say this day, continue as a steadfast people who are ever cleaving unto me, believing in me and knowing that I'm able. For I say it is me, the living God, who gives to the ones who will obey me the way of my life. And it is me, the living God, who gives to the ones who will walk uprightly in me the way wherein they are kept each day. For I say it is me, the living God, who will keep my own in a way that is truth and light and mercy revealed. Now I say, therefore, this day be thankful that you can continue to look to me, believe upon me, and trust each day in me. And I say, be thankful that I will guide you forth, that you can be renewed in the strength, the truth, the power of who I am. For I say, when any people is trusting, believing, and looking to me, then I say they are guided forth in my way. And yes, they are given the mercy, the truth, and the hope that I provide. I say, this day continue as a steadfast people who are ever looking to me, believing upon me and trusting, for I am indeed well able. And I say, the more that you will keep your focus single, that is, upon me, the more you are guided in my way. And I say that my way is humility, my way is life, my way is repentance. And I say, when you serve in the attitude of gratitude each day, then I say you will not find repentance offensive at all. But I say that you will be thankful for that provision which is given unto thee, that you can indeed keep right with me. Now I say, this day when a man will declare that he has no sin, such a man is a fool. For I say that all men have sinned, and yes, indeed, in carnality, continuance of sin is ever present. But I say, through me, a man can grow strong and able to resist the temptation to sin. And I say, when he does indeed have a bad attitude, he can repent of the same, change his way, and walk uprightly in me. I say, this day be glad for the privilege to be redeemed, to be brought forth, to be ever guided in my way. And I say, be thankful that it is me, the living God, who directs you and corrects you as you will adhere unto me. That is, I will guide you forth, I will give you strength, I will give you mercy. And yes, indeed, I will give you the light upon the path. I say, this day, do not, absolutely do not, be living in a sinful imagination, for the same will damn your soul. But I say, learn to bring your thoughts into captivity to the mind of my spirit, that you give not way to sin. For I say, you are not meant to take in the thoughts of demons and hold on to the same. But I say, you are meant to be flushing yourself of those iniquities, not pursuing the course of, nor the activity that the demons would love you to be in. And I say, you are meant to be thankful each day that you can repent, resist sin, and walk uprightly in me. And I say, you are meant to be thankful each day that you can be given the blessedness, the truth, and the mercy of who I am. And I say that you are meant to be thankful that I purpose, direct, and guide you forth. For I say, if you truly consider how much you have to be thankful for, you will have no room to complain. Now I have told you, I desire you to do the same, to dedicate yourselves to thanksgiving during this week unto me. That is, to be glad for the privilege to be born again of incorruptible seed, to be guided in the way of truth and life, and to be given the hope that I alone can give, for I am well able. I say, you are not meant to be subject to the ugly spirits that are ruling in the land. You are not meant to be subject to the attitudes of the world. But I say, you are meant to be subject to me as thy maker, thy God. And I say, you are meant to believe upon me, for I am indeed well able. And I say, you are meant to keep trusting, for it is me who brings you forth. I say, thank me, praise me, thank me, praise me, thank me, praise me, that you can indeed continue in repentance, revolution, the humility way of life that I provide.
As for you, son of man, your people who talk together about you by the walls and at the doors of the houses, say to one another, each to his brother, come and hear what the word is that comes from the Lord. And they come to you as people come, and they sit before you as my people. And they hear what you say, but they will not do it. For with lustful talk in their mouths they act. Their heart is set on their gain. And behold, you are to them like one who sings lustful songs with a beautiful voice and plays well on an instrument. For they hear what you say, but they will not do it. When this comes, and come it will, then they will know that a prophet has been among them.
Just as it is appointed for man to die once, and after that comes judgment.